What's going on out there? Coming to you from our Hollywood studio, I'm Dana Ward with Joslyn Davis.
Hey, hey guys.
And we are here with the one and only Janel Parrish. Can't believe a day just went down.
Did you guys like it?
Yeah, you tell?
We were counting down for a day.
I love it. Yeah, it was definitely the darkest and most intense episode we've ever had, so it was really fun.
So we're dying to know, of course, because we've heard through the grapevine that you found out that you were a little bit before everybody else. Is that true?
I had a feeling since, you know, Mona was A in the books that it would be me. We're not following the books exactly, but the producers did say it could go in that direction, it could not. So of course I hoped I would be A, you know, since it's such a fun character to play. And then about a week before we shot the finale, I got the script, and there it was, and it was just really exciting. So,
Oh my gosh. And the table read must have been intense. I can't remember who told us, if it was Lucy Hale or someone, that everybody was like falling on the ground.
Oh, it was
literally falling and, like, on the ground.
There were lots of gasps, lots of oh my gods. Yeah, it was super, super fun.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
And just to get to see the change in your character, like we were talking about in the episode at the end when Mona makes this complete 180. Like, how did you prepare for that? Or what was going into your character development for that?
That was definitely the biggest challenge. You know, when I got the script, because I'm actually playing three different characters in the finale, you know, I get to play nerdy Mona, I get to play popular Mona, and then crazy Mona. The most interesting part of that is trying to find that switch and be a completely different character. So I had to let go of the character I'd played for 2 years and completely just have a totally different, darker character. And it's funny because before I shot my first scene as A, Marlene came up to me and said, make sure I don't, I change my inflection in my voice, you know, because I always kind of sing-song everything as Mona.
Oh, yeah.
So I was like, ooh, good point, you know?
Yeah.
Just little things like that, little habits that I've created as Mona that just had to completely go away. So that was the biggest challenge, but the most fun part of it all, definitely.
Now, as an actor, obviously playing A, were there any moments that you look back on where you think to yourself, oh, I should have known I was going to be A because it makes sense that this happened?
Well,
I know there's a lot going on from episode to episode. It's probably impossible to keep track of it all.
Well, we got smart writers. I think they do a very good job of making everyone seem suspicious in Rosewood. So I kind of just tried to have that in the back of my mind during every scene that, you know, I could be A since I am A in the books. You know, and I asked Marlene King, I said, am I playing this right? Like, if you are planning on making me A, if there's anything you want me to do differently, I'd like you to tell me. And she's like, no, just keep doing what you're doing. You know, we're creating a story for a reason. Everything will make sense in time. So,
well, I love that, you know, you're A, and people probably that are just tuning into the show, maybe we're thinking like, oh, is the show over now? This is only the beginning, because the end of the episode was like probably the creepiest part for me, when you were, you know, your character's in the hospital and then she's like, this is exactly what we wanted. I mean, what do you think this even means?
There are definitely going to be some new questions that are going to be raised, but you'll get answers as well.
Okay,
cool. That's what season 3 is for, and you'll find out more about everything. I think Mona's got a lot of explaining to do. And I personally, I'm hoping for some flashbacks. Like, I want to put that hoodie on and show everyone how I did things. I want to know how I did things. I don't even know how I did it. So,
oh my gosh, yeah.
Yeah.
So wait, can you reveal, like, who was pretending to be A in those final scenes, in the hoodie and everything?
In the finale, that was me.
I know, in the finale, when we saw you, that was you.
Right.
But all of the previous episodes, ends with someone in a hoodie.
It was different people each time. They were being very smart about it. Sometimes it was male, sometimes it was female, sometimes someone taller, someone shorter, just to throw people off. But it is funny story. The first time they put me in the hoodie and wanted me to run behind Emily during the finale when she's on the phone talking to Maya, they told me to stop running like a girl. Because I'd never put on the A hoodie before, and like, so I guess I was like, you know,
too
like
prancy,
kind of. Yeah. So it's a funny story, but yeah.
And I'm kind of guessing that, I mean, there's no way one person could be doing all this. I feel like there's definitely a team. We saw Lucas and the Black Swan. Who the heck is that? I mean, do you have any guesses
on
that?
I know who it is, but I can't.
You
tell
do
you.
Know.
I do know. Mm-hmm.
You can totally fill
it's
us in
be
if
fun.
You want.
I'll tell you after.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy.
What are you most excited about for fans to kind of learn or find out in this upcoming season?
I'm excited for all the pieces to come together. You know, we've just now started scraping the surface, I guess, of people's connections in Rosewood. I think there are more there are no accidents. Nothing is introduced into the show for no reason. So if Marlene is putting little bits and pieces of the story in front of you, they're all going to come together eventually. So I'm excited for that to just come together.
Yeah, and something we've actually talked about is that we thought that Caleb and Mona were getting really close in the last few episodes.
Very close.
Could that potentially turn into something, you think?
I don't know. Mona's all crazy now. I don't know if he's like into that or what. We'll see.
Oh, yeah, there might be a physical blockade between the two of them.
Yeah, Mona's going to be at the Radley Sanatorium, so.
Oh, hanging
Unless
out
with Dr. Come visit.
Dr. Sullivan. Maybe you're going to be visiting, you think, there?
Could be. Oh, I'm happy she's back, yeah.
I am too. Now, as an actress, you know, you've had so much opportunity to like really be exposed these past few weeks. What's your life been like being A and like having everyone in the world want to talk to you and you know get feedback from
it's
you?
It's been crazy. That next day after the A reveal, I guess we broke Twitter for a little while. You know, we broke some records. I think it was like 38,000 tweets a second were coming in.
Stop.
So I actually haven't even seen all of my tweets. I woke up the next morning and the page wouldn't let me refresh it to an hour before. So I don't even know, like, I'm sorry if I didn't respond to some tweets, you know, I didn't get all of them. So it was kind of crazy, but it's nice, you know, to hear from the fans and to hear what they thought of the finale. So, yeah.
And you've finally been added as a season regular, which we are so, or a series regular, which
yes,
we're so excited
you.
About. What was your reaction when you got that news?
So honored. I'm so honored to be, you know, added to an even closer part of the cast now. So I'm very, very excited.
Can't wait for season
Yay.
3.
Very cool. Well, thank you so much for stopping
by. Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
You have to come back once the next season debuts.
Okay.
And fill us in a little bit more.
Okay, I will.
Good to know.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks to you guys for checking out Clever TV. Make sure you keep it here for all of the latest on Pretty Little Liars. See you soon.
Bye, guys.